Alright, alright, alright. Hello, my fellow mushy blobs of universe dust. My name is Hans, watering god to my leafy minions, obsessed with teal bricks, and berserk for Legos. Today you get to see not one, but two remocs of Lego's airport fire trucks. So put on your swim gear, and let's drench some overly roasted marshmallows. Woo, look at it roast! Alright, and as I always say, onwards to the origin story. Alright, so believe it or not, these are actually original Lego sets. Now this one's a lot harder to recognize because I've completely overhauled it, and that one is pretty obvious. So here in the front we have what originated as 7891, a set from 2006, and back there in the back we've got 60061 from 2014. Now starting with set number 7891 from 2006, Airport Fire Truck, it was right in the era when Lego was first starting to build six stud wide vehicles. And back in 2006, sets these sizes always came in at $9.99 and $14.99 prices here in the US, and it was a good little set. It had two play features that were really geared for kids. One was a retractable water gun that came right out of the middle, so the whole middle of the fire truck was completely hollowed out, and you just reached down inside and pulled up the water gun and pretended that you could spray things around. The other play feature was in the very back, where it was like a tailgate, and you lifted open the tailgate and you were able to pull out this fire tray that held the air tanks and fire mask for the firefighter. And the one thing that bugged me about this particular set was the fact that it was so hollowed out, there was no place for any water tank storage. And I'm a person that's always a sucker for a bit of realisticness. One was the scale, the wheel sizes were too small, the cab was sunk so low between the wheels, the driver had to sit in the middle, there was no obvious compartment for any water storage on it. And these were all things that I wanted to address. The other fire truck, 60061, also named Airport Fire Truck from 2014, was also a pretty good fire truck, and it's actually one of the few city-scaled vehicles that is at 8 studs wide, and it should be. I think these trucks are just massive in size, and 8 studs wide is an appropriate scale for that. It also had, where you see the yellow grills, they would swing up and open. You could open up the side hatches, and there was a large diesel engine in the very back there. And then towards the front, you open that up, and that's where you pulled out the yellow crate, which had all the firefighter equipment. One of the things I didn't really care for on this particular set was just how low to the ground it was. It didn't have the proper ground clearance, and the oh, we've got a call for a fire. Let's go, guys. So even though the 8 studs wide I felt was a good proportional size for this type of fire truck, it sat really low to the ground and looked very schlumpy and kind of has like this turtle head kind of cab to it. The angle of attack on the very front was not representative of actual airport fire trucks. These fire trucks are designed to chase after airplanes that have gone off the runway into like ditches and over hills and stuff like that. So having a sharp angle of attack at the very front of the truck is important for these fire trucks. And 60061 did not have that. The two front windows, I think, you know, that was the best they could do at the time. The other thing that bugged me was that this set only came with one single simple water gun at the very top. Didn't have any water pump on the very nose of the truck, whereas the older set did. It also didn't have the extendable arm water cannon boom. Again, overall, it's a great fire truck, a great starting point for most kids. All right, and I also went to the interwebs to look for real life inspiration and found a lot of modern day really cool looking airport rescue fire trucks. And the first one that caught my eye was the Rosenbauer Panther airport fire trucks. And these things are really cool looking. They already have these really futuristic, sleek, and aerodynamic driving cabs on the very front of them. They've got these water cannons that can swivel and tilt on the very front of the nose. And then they also have these telescoping extendable water cannon arms that are mounted to the very top. And these water cannons also have the ability to pierce a hole into the aircraft and spray water directly inside to help save survivors from airplane fuel. And one thing I learned is that airplane fuel is very hard to extinguish, and it requires a separate foam tank on these trucks that mixes with the water, and the foam helps put out these airplane fuel fires. Airplane fuel burns extremely hot at over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Yikes. The other thing that these fire trucks have are water nozzles on the undercarriage of the trucks. A lot of times that jet fuel can spread out across the tarmac or the ground. ground. And then if that catches fire, a lot of times these fire trucks can end up in a situation where a fire is coming up from underneath the truck. Another popular manufacturer for airport fire trucks is the Oshkosh Striker, another great and futuristic looking airport fire truck. Another manufacturer is the E1 Titan airport fire trucks. And these manufacturers are all making variable sizes. They've got 4-wheeled versions, 6-wheeled versions, as well as 8-wheeled versions. All right, let's start with 7891. And I remocked this so heavily that almost nothing of it remains. I think only the steering wheel and this chassis plate down here at the very bottom are still from the original set. But everything else, it's pretty much an all-new truck. At that point, I probably should have just left the original one alone. So yeah, one of the first mods I ever did was increase the wheel size. When it comes to industrial size trucks, I've already mentioned this before in my previous videos that I didn't like the wheel size that came with it. I don't think it fits large industrial trucks. The other obvious thing to notice is the color change. Yeah. So this has gone through several iterations of reMOC over the last 3 or 4 years. In my latest reMOC of it, I decided to do a complete overhaul, and that's when I decided to do a color change. A lot of these airport fire trucks are this green color, and even a lot of regular fire trucks in Europe are this bright green color. So I really wanted to see a fire truck in this color, and I'm glad I did, because I think it really shows just how cool this green color is on a Lego fire truck. And I think Lego should offer some future fire trucks in this color. So one of the first upgrades I did was transition it to these bigger wheels. Now the other major change that I did in my last reMOC revision was to bump it up to 7 studs wide. Now this is the second time I've shown you a mock that I've done at 7 studs wide. In one of my previous videos, I gave you a glimpse of the camping trailer that I had increased to 7 studs wide. This is an actual vehicle at 7 studs wide, and I really like how it came out. And building a vehicle to 7 studs wide, a lot of times you've got 6 stud wide plates, and then you've got to have a 1x plate at the bottom. I also end up using a lot of these 3x3 and 2x3 plates at the very bottom here as well. Now, of course, breaking up the chassis into a bunch of these smaller plates in order to get the odd number of width can often affect the structural rigidity of the vehicle itself. And the nice thing about this being a very large truck is that it wasn't too much of a concern. I'm using the 1x4x4 door frame, and at the moment I only have it in black or white. And I've got it hollowed out all the way through. I'm actually kind of using it as a entry door for the fire crew to get in and out of the truck. But I do plan on adding some fire gear inside of there eventually. Now, because these fire trucks are going to be part of Paradisa City, my tropical city of the future, the year 2060, all the vehicles in Paradisa City are electric vehicles. So these fire trucks are no exception. These will be electric fire trucks, and the bottom chassis is just going to be a solid structural battery underneath there, and the motor is only take up a very small amount of space, which means more space for water storage. So the back half of this truck is all water storage back there. And of course, being a vehicle of the future, it's also capable of autonomous driving for the Paradisa City's autonomous roadways. And if you want to learn more about that, go ahead and check out my road plates video where I discuss the futuristic modes of transportation and how people are able to get around in Paradisa City. And I talk about a lot of the details of the autonomous roadways. Now, when it comes to 7-stud wide vehicles, obviously Lego doesn't make windshield pieces that are 7 studs wide. So I have to end up fudging it using a 6-stud wide windshield. And what I gotta do is I have to use jumper plates, or I have to use plates with hollowed out studs. And then what you end up with is a transition from 7 studs wide over to the 6-stud wide windshield. And so far on the vehicles that I've done the 7-stud wide conversion, I'm able to make it come out okay looking so far. And here you can see I'm using the jumper plates to mount the windshield, and I was able to sit 2 firefighters side by side. I've got the dashboard right there. I've got a water cannon right here on the front. Now, even though this is like 99% changed from the original set, I did keep some key design elements that preserve the aesthetic of the original set. And one of those is using the 2x2 slope bricks mounted horizontally. The original set had 2x2x4 slope bricks right here at the back. And I wanted to maintain that look, but I just upgraded it to the bow slope shapes to it to give it a more modern look. Now, one reason why this vehicle got scaled up much bigger is because on industrial size trucks, I always try to move the minifigure seating position from the very middle of the vehicle to the left side. And because of that, the chair position has to be raised up to sit on top of this wheel fender piece. When that happens, this whole section gets taller and the windshield moves up. And so that was one of the primary driving factors of scaling this thing up, because once I got to this height, then it made sense for me to just go with the 7 studs wide. And on the back, I gave it some brass fittings for hooking up water hose hoses. I also kept the valve wheel from the original set. Although it's realistically huge and being a fire truck of the future, most of these features are going to be completely automated, but I felt like keeping it on there as a nod to the original set. And just like in real life, a lot of these airport fire trucks have extendable water cannon booms that come up over, and they're able to use these extendable water cannon booms to reach over and put out a lot of these fires. And so I put it on a turntable. It can lift up and then the water cannon can turn from side to side. All right, and let's talk about 60061 airport fire truck from 2014. Again, like I said, the original fire truck was very slumpy looking and sat really low to the ground and had this cab that was sticking really far forward like a turtle head. One of the first conversions I did was to convert it to these bigger wheels. And this was right around 2018 when Lego had just come out with the City Jungle Explorer sets. And then there was also the Volcano Explorer sets that had these bigger wheels on a lot of their sets. And when I saw these wheels, I was like, oh, this is the perfect size for this fire truck. And the other thing that I fixed was the cab. Yeah. So again, as soon as I got a hold of these windshield pieces, that was another epiphany moment where I was like, oh, this is going to look great on this fire truck. And if you watch my Cargo Master Crane video, you'll remember that I used the same exact windshield piece on that as well. And I love how it turned out. It really looks much more like the modern day airport fire trucks. It looks sleek and it looks modern. And positioning it at an angle like this, I think just works out great. And luckily, this 1x2x2/3 slope piece with vents on the top of it works out quite nicely at this particular angle. Another thing that I liked that I did is that by adding this 4x6 roof panel piece up here at the top, gave it a really nice, cool look. And then I also extended it that same look up over the top here. Now, the top edge of this fire truck is a rounded shape, but the windshield pieces have sharp corners and are not rounded. So what I did there was using a wedge plate to give it kind of that transition from sharp corners as it kind of fades away and then transitions into the rounded edge up there at the top. So again, it's a fire truck of the future. It's electric. It's got autonomous sensors on here, but these sensors are also for helping to fight the fires. So it has the ability to do infrared thermal scans so they can look for human heat signatures inside the airplane and find the hottest parts of the fire as well. Another nice feature that I added, the original set did not have a nose water cannon, and so I added that. And so it not only does it have the ability to swivel from side to side, but when I turn it this way, it also has the ability to swivel up and down and any combination of the two. And when it's not in use, it can just be stored down like so, or it can be positioned up like that. I made the roof so that it can just pop off quite easily. And here on the interior, I've got the two firefighters. One can do the driving. I've got the second one operating the cannon using a touchscreen computer right there. I've got storage for the air tank and the face mask. And you can almost see down inside of there. And the whole thing is hollowed out and it is one solid water tank. So the original set had these opening compartments, and inside of here was the diesel engine. And then over here, you could store the gear. And I just got rid of those two features. This is an electric fire truck, so it's got all core batteries down here at the very bottom. And it's got electric motors that sit in the axles in between the wheels. And that's the great thing about electric vehicles, is that the electric motors are very simple and less complicated than internal combustion engines. And they're very compact as well. And they've got tremendous amounts of torque, which torque is great for powering up and down hills. And on this side, I've got the firefighting hose reel. On the back, I really like using these transparent red grill pieces. They just look very futuristic for taillights back there. I'm using these gold 1x1 round pieces. And I think these look great as the copper fittings for attaching the hoses to. So I really like using those. I'm using the newer fireman axe that started coming out on a lot of the firefighter sets. I also made sure to give the firefighters the ability to step up onto here. Another thing that I did was I wanted to use the newer flame yellowish orange color as the stripe right here. And I really like how this color complements the red. All right, and now for the extendable water cannon boom. So the water cannon can stay up here on top and swivel side to side and spray stuff down. It can also tilt downwards when it's fully retracted. And then when the firefighters need to get closer, they can use the extendable boom to get it all the way out here. Now, the friction pin isn't strong enough to hold the weight of this, so it just kind of falls down like that. So maybe that's something I'll work on in the future. And the other feature that I like is that this water cannon can then flip around and then become the needle shell piercing water cannon to pierce into the airplane and spray water and foam. And Lego hasn't added this feature to any of their airport fire trucks before, so I'm really glad that I was able to add this feature. And I really like how that it can switch around between the two features and store away the needle right there. And of course, when it's not in use, it just folds back down. I like using the flame yellowish orange charge for the extendable boom right there. Now, for those of you who have been watching a lot of my previous videos, you know that I'm planning to build a Lego city called Paradisa City, a tropical city in the future, the year 2060. And in my last video, I unveiled that Paradisa City isn't even going to have airports. It has a hyperloop, and that's how people travel from city to city. So that begs the question, what am I doing with these airport fire trucks? And yeah, that's a great question. So I gave it a little bit of thought, and I thought, how can Paradisa City repurpose these airport fire trucks for a more futuristic modern use? And a few of my thoughts are, one of the obvious ones is wildfire fighting. Now, these are monstrous vehicles in real life, and they're not going to be as nimble in mountainous wildfire terrain as, say, their smaller counterparts. These still have some pretty good off-road capabilities, and I think these would be great in defending buildings and homes from wildfires that are approaching. I think this extendable boom can reach up and get really close to the wildfires, put out a lot of fires, not only that are burning at the base of the trees, can also take out a lot of the fires that are burning through the tops of the trees themselves with these extendable booms. Being completely automated, firefighters don't even have to get out of the trucks. With these extendable booms, they're able to attack wildfires as they're driving, say, through a neighborhood that is being attacked by a wildfire, and really be able to overwhelm the fire with a ton of foam and water. Even in real life, I think this is a great idea to use a lot of these airport-style fire trucks for fighting wildfires. The firefighters don't even have to get out of the cabs with this extendable boom right there. And the other thing is that because these trucks are so large, they actually can carry a huge amount of water and don't have to refill with water as frequently. So they're able to stay in the fight much longer. Now, another repurpose for these airport fire trucks is large warehouse and complex fires. A warehouse fire, this truck could probably come up and with its wall-piercing abilities could then puncture right through a wall of a warehouse and get water and foam into the inside of the building to attack the fire very quickly. I've seen videos of modern-day fire trucks fighting building fires. A lot of them are just spraying water through openings in the buildings, such as like windows or doorways. Now, another repurpose I thought that these trucks could be great for is when explosive hazardous materials are involved. The most notorious example of that was the explosion that just happened 6 or 7 months ago in Beirut, Lebanon. Ammonium nitrate exploded and wiped out the entire port and severely damaged nearly half the city. And I think with a fire truck like this, in a more prepared situation where firefighters know what they're dealing with, something like this could come in really quickly, puncture a hole into the warehouse wall, and keep the hazardous and explosive chemicals safe before the fire can get to it. All right, a concept for what these airport fire trucks could be used for in Paradisa City is to go around and water all the plants on all the buildings. Yeah, of course I would say something like that. So when these guys are not fighting fires, they can go around watering plants and trees in Paradisa City and keep them fresh and tropical, because who would not want to live in a city full of fresh tropical plants that are absolutely happy to be watered all the time? That makes you feel like you're part of nature every time you go and walk to the grocery store. All right, and that concludes my fire truck video. So if you guys like my fire trucks, smash the like button and leave some comments. Leave some funny, silly puns. I love comments with puns in them. So yeah, leave some punny comments. And if you're new to this channel, I definitely encourage you to go watch a lot of my other videos. There's a bunch of cool mocs there too. Now feel free to subscribe, hit the notification bell. And on that note, I'll check you all later.